Homes keep crumbling long after the attacks. This is Aleppo, being punished for opposing the Assad regime. Syrian and Russian airstrikes have hit residential areas in rebel-held parts across Syria. But as indiscriminate as the killings may seem, some accuse the regime of deliberately targeting doctors in makeshift hospitals and using denial of medical care as a weapon of war.
It's a clear strategy of war because no one will stay where there's no health care and where there are no schools. No one will stay. A doctor is far more important than a soldier because he can heal people, and they do. And these doctors are amazing. I mean, they stay in the conditions of the worst war ever, knowing that their lives are endangered.
Rights groups say Syria's healthcare system has been systematically dismantled. The World Health Organization has documented a 25% rise in attacks on medical facilities in 2015. Many hospitals work underground, as only around a quarter of healthcare facilities in northern Syria are still operating from their original locations. Nearly 700 medical personnel have been killed since 2011. In Aleppo, roughly 95% of doctors have either fled or been detained or killed. UN investigators found that government forces deny medical care to those from opposition-controlled areas through attacks on medical units, by endangering hospitals, targeting medical personnel, and interfering with patients receiving treatment. Amnesty International has documented the Syrian government's pattern of arresting and torturing medical professionals suspected of treating wounded protesters.
What they get out of it is a control strategy. People are dying, of course, not just of the war trauma, but of kidney failure and heart attacks.
Activists and human rights campaigners are also criticizing Western powers for their inaction, as the attacks are happening during a UN-brokered ceasefire. Mostly civilians are being killed, and those providing help to the wounded are also under attack. And among the victims, the ones pulled out alive from the rubble are considered lucky. Osama Bin Javaid, Al Jazeera.